Hello everyone and welcome to the Pencil Tutors channel. I am Nandiga and today's biology lesson is going to be on the cell organization in humans. Remember last week when I talked about cells? Well, today I am going to teach you on how these cells are arranged to form complex organisms such as humans. Or in other words, I am going to teach you in details about the tissues in a human body. What exactly are tissues? Well, tissues are a group of cells that have the same structure, function, and are arranged together to carry out specific functions. Today, I will be teaching about four different types of tissues, which are epithelial tissues, muscle tissues, nerve tissues, and connective tissues. Let's get started, shall we? First and foremost, we are going to learn about epithelial tissues. Epithelial tissues cover the outer surface of the human body, such as the skin, and the hollow surfaces of the human body, like the digestive tract and respiratory tract. Here we have five different structures of the epithelial tissue that are all adapted to form its very own specific functions. The first structure consists of multiple layers of the epithelial tissue stacked upon one another. This structure can normally be found in the mouth and the esophagus of the human body. The second structure, on the other hand, is very thin and only consists of one layer of the epithelial tissue. This is so that diffusion can occur easily at places such as the lungs, the body cavities, and blood vessels. The next structure has a rather rectangular shape as compared to the structures before this. Other than that, it has a hair-like structure on the top surface known as cilia. This structure of the epithelial tissue can commonly be found in the trachea and the bronchus, which are both structures of the lung. The fourth structure of the epithelial tissue has a cuboidal shape that forms a hollow cylinder. This epithelial tissue can normally be found at the lines of tubules, glands, and kidney ducts. Last but not least, we have the structure of the epithelial tissue that looks very similar to the structure that can be found at the surface of the trachea and the bronchus. But the only difference is that this structure does not have cilia. This structure can be normally found at the small intestine of the human body. Now, let's move on to the second type of tissue, which is the muscle tissue. There are three types of muscle tissues that you should know, which is the skeletal muscle tissue, the smooth muscle tissue, and the cardiac muscle tissue. First and foremost, we must be able to differentiate these three types of muscle tissues based on their structure. The one that is obviously easy to determine is the smooth muscle. This is because it has a distinct spindle-like shape for the cell, which has a nucleus in the middle, which is very different compared to the structure of the skeletal muscle and the cardiac muscle. How do we compare between the skeletal and cardiac muscle? Well, the skeletal muscle and cardiac muscle are both striated. That means they have lines on them. The difference is that the skeletal muscle is normally orderly arranged, whereas the cardiac muscle is normally very branched compared to the skeletal muscle. Let's take a closer look at the functions of these three muscle tissue. First of all, we have the skeletal muscle. The skeletal muscle is the only muscle tissue that is involved in controlled movement, as opposed to the smooth muscle and cardiac muscle, which is involved in involuntary action. The skeletal muscle contracts and relaxes to generate movement in the bones and limbs. Next, we have the smooth muscle. As mentioned before, this muscle is involved in the involuntary action, such as the peristalsis that occurs along the digestive tract. Lastly, we have the cardiac muscle. The cardiac muscle builds up the walls of the heart. It helps the heart to contract and relax so it can pump blood across the entire body. Here's a fun fact. Did you know that the cardiac muscle actually does not need impulse from the brain to contract and relax? That is why, even when the body of the organism is already dead, the heart of the organism can still keep pumping for a while before it stops. Next, we are going to learn about nerve tissues. Nerve tissues are actually made out of neurons or nerve cells. There are three types of neurons, which are the efferent neuron, the interneuron, and the efferent neuron. Here is a simple structure of a neuron. The neuron normally has structures such as the cell body, dendrites, axon, myelin sheaths, and the axon terminal. The function of the nerve tissue is to detect stimuli and send information in the form of electric signal known as a nerve impulse to the muscles or glands. It also regulates and controls the body activities. We have come to the final tissue, which is the connective tissue. The connective tissue consists of various types of tissues and fibers that can be found throughout the whole human body. Today, I will be focusing on 6 different types of connective tissues. The first type of connective tissue is the loose connective tissue. It functions to link the epithelial tissues to the tissues that are below it. Other than that, the loose connective tissue also functions to fix organs in their respective positions. Next, we have the blood tissue, which plays a functional role in the regulation, transportation, and protection in the human body. Other than that, we have the fibrous connective tissue. The fibrous connective tissues form tendons and ligaments. Tendons are structures that connect the bone to the muscle, whereas ligaments are structures that connect the bone to the bone. Another important connective tissue to know is the adipose tissue. The adipose tissue keeps fat under the skin dermis and on the surface of all main organs. Speaking of bones, they are also a type of connective tissue. Bones function to form the body frame of a human or other organisms. Bones also function to protect the internal organs of an organism. Lastly, we have the cartilage. The cartilage is normally located at the tips of bones. It functions to prevent the bones from wearing out and also to reduce the friction between bones during movements. We have now reached the end of our lesson for today. Feel free to ask any question you want in the comment section below. Thanks for watching the video and be sure to like this video and subscribe to our channel. And don't forget, we post videos every Monday, Wednesday and Friday covering physics, mathematics and biology. Bye!